someone your tongue, you will be the next. You will be the next to come and testify that God has done something that you do not expect, that you do not even dream of. Maybe you are dreaming of something that is not important, that something that can bring you more back. But after today's sermon, God is going to give you a positive and big something that you don't expect. I want you to shout a heavenly hallelujah. Believe that after today's sermon, any of your thing that is being seized, your blessing that the enemy has seized, maybe where you are, you're not supposed to be where you're going, supposed to be. Our brother is in Germany, but he didn't have his destiny, not in Germany, he's in US. But at the end, it has come to pass. So if you are looking at me now, maybe where you are is not where you're supposed to be. If you believe that after today's sermon, that you are going to be where God designed you to be, I want you to shout a beautiful hallelujah. Because this testimony that he gave today, grace is here now to continue.
Amen.
Testimony has not stopped. There is a grace to continue. That after today's service, that you are the next to receive that grace. I want you to shout a heavenly hallelujah. You know, in life, what is interested, what is important, you don't need to be asking how your problem started, where you are going through, to be present, where God is taking you to.
Yes.
Not to be rewinding back. How did it start? Let me go again. Let me think again. How does this problem start? How did everything start? No, you go to tell what the way God is taking you. Stop thinking back. You can see he said that he wants to travel home, back home, out of frustration. But God wanted to take him to another place. So many of you are discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Be thinking of where God is taking you to. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And the most important thing is when you're supposed to meet God. Because you can meet miracle and miss God. There are two options. You meet God and meet miracle. You meet miracle and miss God. You can meet miracle and miss God. But you cannot meet God and miss miracle. That's why Bible says, in Matthew 6, that it receive first the kingdom of God. And especially the other thing shall be added. The reason why he says you seek first the kingdom is because when you seek first miracle, because miracle is the back, is at the back. He says other things shall be added, those that are miracles. When you seek miracle first, you might miss God. Because the lowardliness and the luxury and the happiness of those miracles can make you cannot remember God again. That's why you have to come from the front. Seek first the kingdom of God. Because when you seek first the kingdom of God and when he gives you that miracle, your mind will never go back to the world. Because when you seek the kingdom of God, you'll be his spirit. So when that miracle comes, you cannot think of going back to the world, or that miracle will move you, you forget him. That's why I say you seek him first. Then he will give you miracle so that you cannot meet miracle and miss him. Instead, you meet him and meet miracle. So you come from the front. Many people like to go from the back. Miracle first before God. Jesus knows that people need it, but he doesn't want them to miss him, because when you get it, you cannot meet him in the club. So God is going to give you that grace. After today's sermon, God will give you the grace of the person, because I'm going to seek his kingdom. And those other things must be added to you today in the name of Jesus. Because what is important is this. Live a holy life. Avoid sin so that you can access to the wisdom of God. Before you access to that wisdom, you must ask, avoid sin. Sin, when you get wisdom, the wisdom will tell you what to do. You will sit down and be meditating, it will remind you how you go, you succeed in life, and you avoid sin, because devil thinks he can take everything away from you. If devil can take everything away from you, why you should be happy is that he cannot take God away from you. Because if he takes God away from you, that is the end. But if he takes everything, cannot take God, that God he couldn't take away from you, will give you back those things. You can remember the story of Job. So it will give you all things back. So after this sermon, all things that you lost for years, you are going to recover in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our sermon is taking to saying about God says you are necessary. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Everybody is necessary.
in the church. This is our sermon. So as soon as you're necessary, anything you need for somebody that is necessary, God needs to do for you. So that your necessity in the church will come to manifest. After the sermon today, some God is going to give it to you in the name of Jesus. Father, we are taking you as about to hear your word. Father, we need your presence. Come and reveal all that has lost. Father, come and reveal anywhere that is dormant. Come and make it to be active again. Let there be more fire here. Let there be more unction of the Holy Spirit and more anointing here. Father, as we are going to listen to this song, let your spirit, your power, your grace come down in greatness. As we are listening to it, oh God, let them be doers and not only hearers. Let them penetrate in their life. Let this song move mountain. Let this panel break unbreakable. Anything that is impossible in their life, let this sermon make it to be possible. Father, let there be miracle in their life. Let them live a holy life that will please you that the last day they will glorify your truth. Help them, oh God, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Someone open the book of 1 Corinthians 12, verse 12. Yeah, verse 12. 1 Corinthians 12, verse 12.
I read in Jesus' name. Amen. For as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body are one body, being many are one body, so also is Christ.
Bring that in.
For by one spirit are we all baptized into one body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be born or free, and have been all made to drink into one spirit.
Praise the Lord. He's telling us about the church, so that this sermon will make you to know what you are in the church, so that you can have faith that what you are, you are going to come into manifestation. I'm telling you, body, God is using body to describe a church, from head to toe. He used it to describe a church, that the way body is, the function of the body to the toe is where the church is. He said that we are members of one body. Like head, some people in the church are functions of a head. Some people are functions of ear. Some people are functions of eyes. Some people are functions of nose. Everything in the body, both inside and outside, this is how church is. And it's telling that everybody in that one body, when people don't know what is church, it's supposed to take you, anybody you see as your body. Because maybe the person you're sitting with is doing the function of ear. You are doing the function of nose. So all of you are in one body. But when you take it, it's not from you, which means are not from one body. Church is one body. So as you're sitting now, everybody has what they have. Before we reach the end, we see that everybody has his function in the church. There are people that are doing the work of nose. I can explain everything to you. Eyes, intestine, brain. You use body to describe. Doing the work of hand, functions of hand, leg. There are people God wants to use the function of hand, but therefore God doesn't want to hand them to operate that hand. But after today's sermon, is your function is like hand and leg, and devil is stopping you. God is going to give you that function in the name of Jesus. Yeah. So he's telling us that you are one body and one spirit. That one spirit is saying to you through baptism, because it's that spirit that will lead you to baptism. Not baptism will lead you to spirit. When you get that spirit, it will lead you to be baptism and it become one body. So today's sermon is going to help you in the name of Jesus. You don't need to say, I don't need this or I don't need this. No, you are not important. I use the function of direction in the church. Direction. Telling people, do this, instruction, advice, and direction. And nose has the function of smell, spiritual things. So everybody has their gift. Hand is the action. So I cannot say to the Lord, I don't need you. Because when you give that direction, you need hands to put it in action. There are people in the church that are hand. So hand will put it in action. But devil is battling your hand. Your hand is going to become active from today in the name of Jesus. Let's start from 15.
If the foot shall say, because I am not the hand, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body?
Praise the Lord. And then read 16.
And if the ear shall say, because I am not the eye, I am not of the body, is it therefore not of the body?
Praise the Lord. Because in the church, as everybody is taking that everybody as one body, there are people that are function of pastors, people, elders, people, teachers, people, singers. prophecy. Everybody has his own, and everything is weighted as one part. Here cannot say, teacher cannot say, because I'm not a singer, I am not a part of the church. Or because you don't have gift, you see yourself, you're not a part of the church. Or because I'm not a committee, you're not a part of the church. You say, foot cannot say, because I'm not hand. Foot are people that go for errand for the church. It's the message. Go here, go here, go here. Then hand that are doing the action, we say, because I'm not the one going the message, I'm no more important. Or because I see, then here we say no, because I'm not the one giving directive. Here are the hearers. Hearers in the church. He said, am I only people hearing? Because I'm not girl, I'm not the one that is going to be seen directing things. You say that I'm not part of the body. It's not true. Everybody in the church has their role. It's important for the gospel. Foot cannot say, I'm not. If everybody become ear, who will be ear? Eyes. If everybody become hearers, who will preach? If everybody become pastors, who will listen? If everybody become choir, who will dance? Who will respond? So everybody have their own roles in the word of God. Praise the Lord. So today, God is going to open your eyes. There are people that are helpers. Helpers are the people that are hand. The devil is battling them. They don't want them to. They don't want you to get that thing. There are people that have in mind, if God bless them, they will help the church. The devil will not allow them to be blessed. Those ones are hand and foot. People with that go with hand and go with foot. There are different types of gift and different oppression in the church. Everybody in the world has, the church has their own gift. So God is saying that church is one body. Anybody you're seeing as a neighbor, see him as a part of your body. Either you are ear, she is nose. Praise the Lord. Then read from 18.
But now had God set the members, every one of them, in the body as it has pleased him.
Praise the Lord. Say no, he doesn't consult anybody. As it has pleased him, he has set everybody in the church. He has pleased himself, you're going to be my teacher, you're going to be my pastor, you're going to be a choir, you're going to be an usher, you're going to be a director, you're going to be a listener, you're going to be a worker driver. Any work he gives you, this is as he pleases him. He doesn't consult anybody. This is his sovereign power. He shares those gifts in the church. He's still even in the church. Everybody has function. So his church is a body. So you're angry to ask yourself now, what are you in the church? Am I nose? Or am I ear? Am I head? Am I hand? What I am. You're going to know who you are today in the church. So that's why he's telling you everybody is important. Praise the Lord. Then read from 19.
And if they were all one member, where be a body?
Yeah, read 20, yeah.
But now are there many members, yet but one body.
Praise the Lord. He said if everybody are one, where be a body? If everybody are ears, then who will do the work of nose? Who will do the work of hand? There are people that do the head of head. Head is the carrying something inside. There are in the church. Now, before we go to last, you will see that there is a word inside the body, there is a word that is not seen that are inside. So in the church, there are the people that you don't see that are inside. And you think that those ones are left function. For example, you can't see bread. Better in the church. Bread is a part of the body. And it does the body's being work. When you remove bread, you cannot sing again. So back we will see here, Bible say here, those that you think that are weak in the church are important. Those that you think that are very, very feeble, the Bible calling feeble and weak. The weak ones like intestine. In the body, the intestine is very, very weak, soft. Heart, everything inside soft. But you remove one now to see whether you believe. So those one you think in the church that are very, very weak, they're important for God. God needs them. Bible says I do not come because of the righteous, I come because of the sinners. So those ones that are outside cover the ones that are inside. You that are already born again Christian, cover the ones that are not born again Christian. You have to protect them, back them with your spiritual life. That one day they're going to repent. Praise the Lord. Then read 21.
And the eyes cannot say unto the hand, I have no need of thee. Nor again the head to the feet, I have no need of you.
Praise the Lord. He said that eyes cannot say to the hand, I don't need you. Eyes are people that direct, as I said before. People that see, for example, in the church, there are people that come to me. You don't know what you have in the church. Some people are that use eyes for directive. See, pastor, do it like this, do it like that. Pastor, see, let's do this. I say, yeah, these people that this is our works you have. Some people will come say, see, well, I'm suggesting this type of thing. That is the work of an eye. Direct. See something, you come. Some people know, smell Holy Ghost. When you smell, you tell people what you saw. Some people are eyes also as a prophecy, eyes as a directive. Some people do the function of ear. They hear from God and say. Some people do the function of hand in the church. They use their hand. What they get from in hand also means income to help the church. Food is errand.
You use your foot and give message. Many people, as you are in the church, you have your own talent. That is a gift for the church, but you don't know. So anybody here, God wants to use one way or the other. God is going to give you your gifts. In the name of Jesus. Read 22.
Nay, much more those members of the body which seems to be more feeble and necessary.
Praise the Lord. He said those members, you feel that feeble means weak and necessary. Another one, he said, hand cannot say to the ear, I don't need you, for example, rich and poor. If you come to the church, you see rich people and poor people. And poor will not say to the rich, because you are not rich, say to you, because you are not poor, you are not rich, I don't need you. If you are doing like that, it's a sin. Rich and poor. Hand say to the feet, because maybe hand is long, nose is small. You feel you're rich, or you have more power. You don't say, I don't need it. It's a lie. You need is your body. Yeah. When you tell that person that you don't need it, there is a function of that thing in your life, it will disappear. Maybe that person will be a function of ear in the church. And in your life also, you say because you are rich, you don't need the person. That function will get away from you. You see, everybody are well checked. When you say to the church, I can do without you. That person you see can do without, you can see what she raised. Those ones you think that are feeble are necessary. Feeble means weak. The weakest one are important even before God than you. That's feeling that you don't need them. They are important before God. I say those that are need, that's why I say you are necessary. Those that are weak in the church are necessary. Those people are the people that Christ came for. Because the weak are inside the intestine. Those that are weak, they have their function. Intestine have a very good function, but it's weak, you cannot see it. Heart is doing very big function. Prayer is doing very big function. There are people that are like that inside the church, they are very weakest one, they are weak. That is made the sinners. You cannot say because you are a sinner, I don't need you. You will see when she will read, whereby say those that are already dependent is not those he needs. Because those ones already got in their salvation. Whom he needs is those that have not repented. Because those ones, the Bible call it crumbling. So he said that those that have already repented, he will use to back up those that have not repented. So you don't need to say, I don't need you, or because you're not read, or because you're not working in my working class, I don't need you. It's a sin. Because Bible call you one party, praise the Lord. So any class God wants you to be in the church. Many of you, because God, where God handed everything is church. Not any given in the Bible church, it's like your mountain church. So when there is a class, God is expecting you to be in the church. Maybe God doesn't want you to be in that class. After today's sermon, God is going to give you that class in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Then read 23.
And those members of the body which we think to be less honorable, upon this we bestow more abundant honor.
Praise the Lord.
Our uncommonly parts have more abundant comeliness.
He said, those people that are part of the body you think that is less honorable is where we posted more honor. Those people in the church you think that are not honorable, you take them as nonsense. Is the world of heaven are regarding more than you, because they already got in your own salvation. Those ones that are still sinners, that's what he said, they bestow more honor. Honor is covering. When someone is naked, now you are naked. But when you cover with a cloth, you are honor. So that honor means that you cannot, in a church now, there are people that are sinners. You have to honor them. Don't go out and say what they are doing. Because when you go out and say what a child is doing in the church, to outsiders, you are blaspheming the church of God. And you are making people that doesn't go to church to be talking evil of church. That's why he said they bestowed more honor to those sinners. Anything you see them doing, go and tell the pastor or the elder. They will call the person to order. You have to, he said, those they honor more, you have to cover them. Because when you are going outside to see who say what people are doing in the church, you are blaspheming the gospel. Especially when you are saying it, we are members of the church, outsiders. Even the people that doesn't go to church, you are giving them more power not to go to church. That's why the Bible says, there they bestow more honor. Those people that are sinners in the church, those people that already got salvation is not important, because Jesus came for the righteous, not for the sinners. And you can hear in 2 Corinthians 12:9, say, your grace is sufficient and your strength is made perfect in weakness. What are the weakness? The weakness. That strength making them to be strong, so that we will help them to repent. Is great, gradually by gradually, growing in the Lord, gradually by gradually. And he says again, Psalm 8:2, out of the mouth of babes and suckling infants shall obtain praise. Those people in the church that are without vessel are suckling. They shall obtain praise. So God leads everybody in the church. Everybody are necessary before God. Those people, they think that you're highest before God. God come to the church, that you will pass yourself and be looking for those sinners, because he needs them. Because he needs them to be repented. So that at the last day they will meet him, he meets him on the cloud. He needs people to meet him. Praise the Lord. So in the church, if you are that feeble part that are very, very weak in the church, God is going to give you that grace. And his strength is going to make you to be strong. So that you can be to the class he wants you to be. Because when you are strong, then that class will start to manifest. That thing he wants you to be in the church. That's your dream. You come to your manifestation so that you can use your dream and serve God. Praise the Lord. Jeremiah 24.
For our common parts have no need, but God has tempered the body.
Read it again.
For our common parts have no need, but God has tempered the body together, having given more abundant honor to that part which lacks.
Praise the Lord. He said in 24, for our common parts has no need. Common parts means part of the church that are common, that are already repented, those ones that are useful, that are presentable, people that are already born again. He says, yeah, those commonly part are no need. We don't need of them because they have no spiritual term. They know their life are right. When they have problems, they know what they will do. That problem will be solved. And see, but what is interesting, you see, for our God tempered the body together, having more abundant honor to the parts that lacked. Those that lacked, the weaker in the church that doesn't know even everything. Doesn't know their left, doesn't know their right. Those one God are interested in. Because he doesn't want you to perish. He doesn't want you to go to fire. So what is your sin saying that you lack? Those are lack spiritual sensitivity, spiritual blessings. There are spiritual things you're supposed to know, observe. When you know it, it will see that it will be helping you. You need spiritual blessings. Even if somebody doesn't pray for you, when you stay in your house, you will know when the power of God has come and tell you to start praying. Like our brother John, he said at times when Brogan was there, Brogan would wake him up at times by 12 o'clock in the midnight and say, let's be praying for the church. Pray for the women, we pray for the children. You have to be knowing, doing this prayer, this thing that doing, I don't know. Yesterday he was telling me, you know, Brogan, two of them, they wake up. This is, I pray for the children, I pray for the elders, pray for the children, be praying for this person, pray for. So those things, this essentially we will do it. God will know that you want the growth of the church in power, then he will bless you. Praise the Lord. So those people that are, if you lack anything, I don't know any of you that lack something, say that they are more important, they were more interested in those that are lacked. So any of you that lacks anything that you need to be somebody in life, God is going to provide that in the name of Jesus. Yeah. You are not going to lack anything. Anything you need for the growth of your life, from becoming somebody in this world, God is going to bring it to you. Because he said that they are more important to honor them that part that are lacked. So that part that you know in the church, are you here? Are you here? You lack something. You lack something that will make you, to help you to be a blessing to the church. God is going to provide strength to you in the name of Jesus. You are not going to lack anything. If it's paper that you lack, that will make help you to be weak in the church, God is going to surprise you with a miracle paper in the name of Jesus. Yeah. If it is money that we lack, that will make you to be weak in the church, God is going to surprise you with that money. In anything, if it's movement, touring, or is it paper, anything, is it work, anything, connection, opportunity, anything that will make you to be those that the Bible regards as the lack, God is supplying you those things. Both physical and spiritual needs. Because you can see that people that are lacked. So I don't know what you lacked. God is supplying it for you now in the name of Jesus. Both physical one and spiritual one in the name of Jesus. Then he reads 25.
That there should be no schism in the body, but that the members should have the same care for one another.
No schism means no division. In the church there is no division because you cannot divide your body. You cannot separate your body. Nose, I don't like you. Hand. You cannot divide your body. There are one. You cannot remove anyone. That's what I said. There will be no division in the body. There is no division. Because all of you are one. Love, charity. When God blesses you, you become a blessing to others. When God, when another one is crying, you cry with the person. Because when nose is paining you, we cry. It will affect our hand. Because if hand touch nose, we shatter, you remove. Anywhere that is having problem, our other part will suffer with them. If your member of church is having problem, you cry with each member. If it's rejoicing, you rejoice with the member because you are one body. No division, no discrimination. Because if a member of the church is blessed, it will affect you one way or the other. Because it's part of the body. So you have to rejoice with the goodness of a member and rejoice with when the member is not having good. So some people in church, when a member has problems, start laughing. You are laughing at your body. God is taking everybody as one body. So everybody in the church is supposed to be praying for each other. Let me tell you the secret that because it's a part of your body. God is seeing every one of you as one body. So we have to be praying for each other because when this person is blessed, you're blessed. Because when you're praying for this each other, it's like you're praying for your body. It makes fast answers.
answers to prayers. Many of you will be getting your miracle. That's another secret. Because God sees us one body. So when you're praying for this person, you're praying for yourself. All of you at the house, you call people them and pray. You're praying because all of you are doing one function or the other in the church. Praise the Lord. Then read another one.
And when that one member suffer, all the members suffer with it. Or one member be honored, all the members rejoice with it.
Yes, 28.
27. Now ye are the body of Christ and members in particular.
Wow. Praise the Lord. He said, now you are the member in Christ, body of Christ. Member in particular means in particular assignment you are assigned to. You are member of body of Christ in particular. Which area are you assigned? There are people that are assigned to become pastors, elders, workers, ushers, singers, cleaners, helpers. Many things. Work in church are plenty. There are plenty. So he said, in a particular member at their body, now everybody has what the function, knows has the function is. They say every finger has their function. This is so in the church. So he said, you are members of everybody has his own function in particular. You ask yourself, which function are you? Because devil is blinding people's eyes. They cannot see so that they cannot see the light of the gospel. Because when you see the light of the gospel, you know where area you are assigned. Then you know where to tackle. You know how to call God for God to bless you. He said in a particular area you are assigned. If you know, don't know any particular area you are assigned, God is going to reveal it to you in the name of Jesus. And God is going to bless you. That's your particular. You will use it. People will know you are using it. Because Bible said there was a time Jesus came to a city. It noised that he was around. And the people came and let him. Maybe when you go, it doesn't noise when you are around. God is going to bless you. Anytime you enter, it will noise that you are around. And they will get up and see you. They will come and see you because God has given you a better corner. You have known what you are in the church. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. And God has set some in the church, first apostle, secondly prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gift of healings, helps, governments, diversities of tongues, are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers, are all workers of miracles, have all the gift of healings, do all speak with tongues, do all interpret, but covet earnestly the best gift, no. and yet show I unto you. More excellent way.
Yeah, I read. He said God has sent some in churches, first the apostles. There are people who are gave big gift of apostles, not everybody. He said some apostles, first apostles, then secondary apostles are the people that preach like something like Apostle Paul. Then have secondary prophets, people that listen, get foretell things to come, tell you what is going to happen. There are people who give the gift of teachers, people that read the Bible, meditate and teach. There are people who give the gift of help. Helping the church in one way or the other with your eyes. There are many people, so at times you come and just give some suggestion here. It's a help. People that help financially, people that help. There are many, you know yourself what you have participated in this church. Some people that give the gift of help. And the same again, there are people that have the gift of government administration. Some people will come to me, you do it this way, government means administration. Everybody, you have your work. Somebody comes to, let's do it this way. Let me say, okay. So I cannot be everything. People, you have your own. So that's why this, when God tells you, reveal to you, that is your own gift in the church. You come and tell us and say, let's meet like this, meet like this. So that is government administration. People that know that's the gift of organizing. Because when you are doing this thing, God will be blessing you because you are helping in the church. You are proving that the church is part of your body. I said that there are people that give that diversities of tongue. Speaking in tongues, different types of tongues, different types of tongue. Then 29 says, are all apostles, are all prophets, are all teachers, are all workers of miracles? Is it everybody that's going to be prophets? No. As you are all apostles, everybody cannot be apostle. Are all teachers, everybody cannot be teachers. Because if you are a teacher, who will listen to you? I say, are all prophets, if everybody prophesy, who we are going to listen to, who we are going to prophesy to? That's why I say, are all miracle workers, if everybody become miracle workers, who will? That's why it's up to you. No, everybody has their own gift. And that is it, have all the gift of healing, to all speaking thoughts? No, everybody have their own function. If it's like this, what will everybody will choose one ear? Or I don't know which part of body will choose best. Father will say, I will choose only A. So if everybody become A, who will do the function of the part? So everybody has their function in the Lord. Praise the Lord. And as he read in 31, he said, but convert earnestly the best gift, and I will show you the more excellent way. He's telling you here that you choose the one you want. Because all this gift that is mentioned here, everybody cannot have it in some. So anyone that you choose that you want, you are willing for it, then you talk to God, then He will choose it, tell you the more excellent one, the more that the ones that are important for you. Because all the gifts that are mentioned here, there are many. Bible says there are many spiritual blessings in heavenly places. There are many things to do for God. So this one that you saw here now is not all. There are many gifts, there are many things to do in the church, singing, help, financial, leading, showing, other things, many things. So when you convert, when you want them, when you want to give, that He will tell you, He will show you the more excellent way, show you other things to do. Praise the Lord. So you are going to tell God to show you, because when God shows you, it will help you. Because when you are in the church, you don't know your function, it's difficult for you to know the spiritual access to your dreams. Because these dreams need spiritual. Because anybody in the world that doesn't have a dream is like a dream. That's why I always tell you at times, have dream. Have, it's important. Have dream. Have dream. Dream is very, very important. If you meditate and say this is what you want, you pursue it. As our brother meditated and pursued it, it worked. You pursue the prayer. The word is somehow. There are times you will say you have reached to the end. Don't run again. You have to make U-turn. And making U-turn is a little bit difficult. If you can see Moto will reach the end of the road, and that road is not there. When he's making U-turn, you see what the driver will be doing. He'll do it like this, he'll do it like this. I'm putting ash here, putting ash here. I'm done before you. It's like that. When there's a place we meet in the life, it seems the road has ended. Then you look for alternative to turn. And when turn, it doesn't seem so easy. It will you make you like this, it will make you like this. You turn, you look, then you see a road before you enter. So that is life. So when you see a situation you are facing through, you think that it has come to the end of the road. It's not the end of the road. You have to make U-turn. Many of you now are looking at me that you're on the stage of making U-turn. And that stage is seeing you to see that God has forsaken you. God has not forsaken you. That U-turn, your turn, continue to you meet the right road. Praise the Lord. You are going to get the right road. And after making that U-turn, you're making now. I prophesy your life today. This is the end of your U-turn. You are meeting the right road. Because some people to make that U-turn still enter the wrong road. Some drivers still make that you enter the wrong road. But some end U-turn have entered the right road. It's difficult for you, you are turning. But that turning is ending today in the name of Jesus. Amen. And you are going to enter the real road. Amen. That will lead you to where you are going. That U-turn has been turning all these years from country to country, from state to state, from state to state. It's ending today in the name of Jesus. Amen. God is going to use it.
Amen.
You are going to enter the real road.
Amen.
That will guide you to your destination.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. So you are going to, as we are going to pray now, what we are going to ask God, I know, what am I in the church? Am I the comely or the feeble? You know, Bible says that comely. Comely is already the people that already repent. The feeble are the weaker ones that are assisting us. There are sinners in the church. You can everybody in the church are not holy. And Bible called them weakers, and the word this is the one God said He covers them. They are inside the body. The body covers, it's better than cover intestine and other things. So you have to cover them. Don't expose their sin outside in order not to blaspheme the gospel. That is the meaning. Not to blaspheme Christ. You have to cover everything inside. God said He needs them. He made them to repent. So He asks yourself, which one are you? Are you comely or are you feeble? It doesn't mean you're a worker. It can still be a worker in the church and become comely. So tell God that He wants you to bless you spiritually. You want to be comely. Praise the Lord. That you want to be those that are comely. Don't want to be feeble. That you want to get out from the stage of feeble. Because the comely means you are already spiritual. You don't need directions of any pastor or anybody. You can do anything you want to do. If you say, I want this, you know, the Holy Ghost will direct you. You know what to do. Sin will not distract you. You reach your destination. That is the comely. So God is going to give you that grace. As this prophecy has prophesied in your life, about turning you, so you are going to the right road that will lead you to where you want in life. As you are going to pray for God to give you comely, God is making you to be comely in the church today. And He will give you wisdom that you will use. You must surely achieve your dreams. Stand up, let us pray. Begin to ask God for forgiveness. Tell God for forgiveness in any way you have sinned against Him. If any were sinned against you, forgive. Have mercy. Say, merciful Father. The blood of Jesus gives us from all sins. You cannot say because you are faithful that God said He honors you because you are the faithful ones in the church. Because He honors the faithful ones in the church because He protects them so that He wants them to repent. He makes you to continue in sin. You cannot say because the grace is sufficient to continue in sin. You have to repent. Because when you become faithful, when you rapture comes, where will you be? He's petting you now, as a favor. Honoring you as a favor. I honor, He honors you more for you to repent. You don't want to repent.
until rapture comes. Do not say because grace is sufficient and continue in sin. May God forgive you your sins in the name of Jesus Christ. Begin to tell God to make you complete the church. People that are already, that you want to go out from the weaker vessel, the weaker, the favor. That it will make you complete so that you will be spiritual, it will help you. Make you to become those that are already prepared, those that are already useful in the church. It's true that it's covering the sinners, making them to repent. Because this is why he came for the sinners, not for the righteous. May God help you. May God only make you to heal the spirit that will guide you to live a holy and righteous life. Worship God in truth and the spirit. Anything you are doing, you know if it's not of God, you stop it. Person will not tell you to stop it. Person will not tell you to stop it. May God answer your prayers in the name of Jesus. May God help you to discover what you are in the church. Anything God wants you to be, every part of the body, you check from head to toe. Because if I begin to mention their past one by one, we will not go here today. Maybe that one is letter. You can go home and meditate from there. Go and bring a map. Look all parts of the body. Which one are you in the church? Mass or tolerance? Which one are you in the church? Tell God to give you the one you are. So that you know that you are part of the body of Christ. You know your assignment in the church. May God answer your prayers in the name of Jesus. For as your children have surrendered, they have asked for forgiveness, have mercy upon them. Father, give them the grace to make it. As you say, so that are comely and the weaker ones. Father, those weaker ones, help them. Make them to be strong. Make them to repent. Make them to know you more. As you say, seek first the kingdom of God and righteousness, other things shall be added. But let them seek you first. Because many of them have already received miracle first before knowing you, and that miracle made them to miss you. Then now you have brought them back to you for them to seek you first before that miracle. May miracle go to you in the name of Jesus Christ. May unmerited favor go to you in the name of Jesus. The testimony you do not expect, you will come here and testify. Anything that is your heart, is may God give it to you. Anything that is your dreams, may God give it to you. And come all of you with the blood of Jesus. May this week be a week God will bring to your mind. You meditate on something that will lead you to your destiny. A week you will sleep, God will talk to you. You see something, say, hey, this idea is good. A week you will meet miracles, meet people that will favor you. A week you will meet